Wondering where to find Crying Obsidian in Minecraft? This video is going to explain where to find it and what crafting recipes involve Crying Obsidian. Crying Obsidian is a new block that has been added in the 1.16 update. It was first introduced in the 20W09A snapshot, but there have been several changes with each snapshot afterwards. This is based on the snapshot since then. If anything has changed before the 1.16 update is released, I will try to do a video on Crying Obsidian. The Crying Obsidian looks similar to the Obsidian block, but has a purple texture similar to magma blocks, and has a dripping effect giving off purple particles, making the Obsidian block appear to be crying. To mine Crying Obsidian, you have to use a diamond or a netherite pickaxe. The block has a blast resistance of 1200. This is similar to Obsidian and blocks like Ancient Debris, the Anvil, and a block of netherite. Crying Obsidian cannot be pushed by a piston, and the block cannot be destroyed by the Ender Dragon. Where you can find the Crying Obsidian block is in Ruined Portals. These are structures that were added in the 20W16A snapshot, and appear in the Nether and the Overworld in any biome. Ruined Portals can be underground, underwater, or on the surface in the Overworld. Crying Obsidian and Obsidian make up the frame of the Ruined Portal. Also, Crying Obsidian can be found in Bastion Remnants. So this is a new structure added in the 20W16A snapshot that generates in the Nether Waste, Crimson Forest, Warp Forest, and the Soul Sand Valley in the Nether. It is occupied by Pinklands, Hoglins, and Magma Cubes. There are four different structures that make up the Bastion Remnant. These are the Housing Unit, the Treasure Room, the Hoglin Stables, and the Bridge. In the Bastion Remnant, there are four different loot chests that correspond to different structures. Three of these have Crying Obsidian as possible loot. In the bridge chest, which can be found in the bridge part of the Bastion Remnant, you can get 3 to 8 pieces of Crying Obsidian, and there is a 13.2% chance of this happening. In the treasure room, at the bottom of this room, there is a loot area with 1 or 2 generated chests. You can get 1 to 5 pieces of Crying Obsidian at 29.4% chance. The last one is there is a chest that is called Other. So I assume this can be found in the housing units or other miscellaneous areas. So you can get 1 to 5 pieces of Crying Obsidian at 31.5% chance. If you want to know more about the Bastion Remnant, there will be a card on the top right. The next way to get Crying Obsidian is by bartering with Pinklands. So how bartering works with Pinklands is that you give the Pinkland a gold ingot. You can either do this by dropping the ingot near the Pinkland or right clicking the ingot onto the Pinkland. When they do this, they will take the gold ingot and give you an item in exchange. So Pinklands have a 9.43% chance of giving you 1 to 3 pieces of Crying Obsidian. Now let's talk about what you can actually do with the Crying Obsidian. It cannot be used as a frame for Nether portals. So Crying Obsidian is part of the crafting recipe for the Respawn Anchor. So the recipe is 6 pieces of Crying Obsidian and 3 blocks of glowstone. So the Respawn Anchor can be placed in the Nether, and what this does is it allows you to set your respawn point as the Nether. You have to charge the Respawn Anchor with glowstone blocks. There is a dial on the side of the Respawn Anchor that indicates the charge, so the maximum amount can be 4. Each time you respawn, it uses 1 charge, and if the Respawn Anchor is uncharged, you will die and you will respawn at the world spawn point. If you try to place the Respawn Anchor in the Overworld, it will explode.